Hello, children. For recent time, I didn't give any videos for the social science. So from this video, we will continue the next chapters and the pending lessons, what we are having. So just a minute, I will share the screen now to you. Just a minute. So in the last session's first lesson, outbreak of First World War, we saw up to League of Nations, how it formed, how its compositions and structure, that and all we saw in the last session or in the last slides. So now we are moving to the next concept is objectives of League of Nations, or in the later stages it was it changed its name as a United Nations Organization. Now we are going to move into the objective or aim of the League of Nations. The twofold objective of the League of Nations was to avoid war and maintain peace in the world, and to promote international cooperation in economic and social affairs. So the main aim and objective of League of Nations is to maintain peace and avoid war between or among the international borders, or in the economic and social affairs of the different nations, those who are members in the League of Nations. That's their main objective. So the main objective is to avoid war between the two nations of the members of League of Nations, and also maintain a peace among or around the across the world. The next point is, the League intended to act as a conciliator and arbitrator, and thereby resolve a dispute in its early stages if wars should break out. Despite arbitration, the members should apply sanctions to the aggressor, first economic and then military, which means the League always plays to act as a intended means plan to or place to act as a maintain a friendly relation or settling the dispute between the two nations. Arbitrator means intermediator, or a group of nations or any individual nation or a League of Nations involving in settling the disputes between the conflicting nations. Conciliator means creating a friendly relationship between the conflicting nations or nations between the two nations. So the second objective of League of Nations is to, it acts as a intermediator between the conflicting nations to create a healthy and better relationship between the conflicting nations. Second one. And also if there is any war is going to happen or it's been declared by the any nation, that and are all solved or involved by the League of Nations before it is getting more devastation or more losses to the both nations. So the next objective of League of Nations is, difficulty in achieving the objectives was increased from the beginning by the absence of three great powers, namely USA, Germany, and Russia. So their main objective of League of Nations is to increase or achieve the participation of the two major nations from the European continent. So these three, USA, Germany, and Russia, from the beginning onwards, they are not showing any interest to becoming a member in League of Nations. So in the later stages, in 1926 and in 1934, USA and Germany were joined, while Germany got resigned in 1933. Russia was expelled in 1939. So which means from the beginning itself, the European powers like Germany, USA, Russia, they were not showing any interest towards creating peace among the world, and they're not interested to become a member of League of Nations, and they were resisting to or refused to join in the League of Nations Association. So in the later stages, USA and Germany were joined in the specific years, in 1926 and 1924. So in 1939, Russia was expelled in 1939. Expelled means, so officially forcing to leave from the League of Nations. So with this, the objective of League of Nations ended. Now we will move to the next slide or next concept. So our next concept will be activities of the League of Nations. League means League of Nations. So what are the activities or work or functions, roles done by the League or League of Nations? In general, we'll see in this slide. So first activity or first role will be, or first work will be, League was called in to settle a number of disputes between 1920 and 1925. So during or between these years, 1920 to 1925, League was called and to settle the disputes between different nations. Those were having a war or misunderstanding or conflicts between their frontiers or between their economic and other social issues. So during this year, 1920 to 1925, League was very vigorously involved in settling the disputes between the warring nations are conflicting nations. That was its first and very important activity or work of the League of Nations. So the next activity which was done by League of Nations is, in 1920, there a dispute arose between Sweden and Finland over the sovereignty of the Åland Islands. The League ruled that the islands should go to Finland. So as I said in the first point, in 1920 itself, there is a dispute or clash started between Sweden and Finland. So sovereignty means these two nations were trying to completely or dominate the or control the Åland Islands. So this led to, there is a clash and dispute between Sweden and Finland. So in this issue, in 1920, League of Nations interfered and involved in this issue and settled this clash or dispute between Sweden and Finland. This island should go to Finland. So League of Nations, after involving in this dispute and giving a decision or judgment as this island, Åland Island, should go to the Finland territory or should under the control of Finland. This was the next activity or work done by the League of Nations. So next will be, in the following year, League was asked to settle the frontier between Poland and Germany in Upper Silesia, which was successfully resolved by the League. So there is a dispute, frontier dispute or clash between Poland and Germany. So this, there is a clash between Germany and Poland for dominating or coming, capturing or conquering the region of Silesia. So this led to there is a clash and dispute, frontier or territory clash between Poland and Germany. So this led to there is a collapse between Poland and Germany. So after getting news of the dispute or conflict between Poland and Germany, League of Nations getting or interfere or involved in the in this dispute between Poland and Germany and resolve the issues between Germany and Poland for the region of capturing the Upper Silesia or Silesia. So this issue was solved or decided to hand over to the specific nations, which was done by League of Nations. The next or third dispute between other nations is the third dispute was between Greece and Bulgaria in 1925. So Greece invaded Bulgaria and the League ordered a ceasefire. After investigation, it blamed Greece and decided that Greece was to pay a reparations. So in 1925, the third activity or work done by the League of Nations is there is a dispute between Greece and Bulgaria. Greece invaded Bulgaria and this led to a lots of damaging or loss caused by Greece, which created more conflict and dispute between Greece and Bulgaria. So after investigating these issues and matters, League of Nations blamed Greece and League of Nations decided and you have to repay the do the reparations to Bulgarian nation. This was the decision given by the League of Nations to Greece. Due to the Greece invasion of Bulgaria, there was a devastating loss and more collapse in their normal life. So restoring the peace of Bulgaria, League of Nations interfered in this issue and settled the disputes between Greece and Bulgaria. This is the third activity or work to settle the dispute between Bulgaria and Greece. This took place in 1925. And the League of Nations decided a judgment to Greece as to repay the losses and the reparation that has to be borne on by the Greece nation. So next point is, thus the League had been successful until signing of Locarno Treaty in 1925. So before or until the signing of Locarno Treaty in 1925, completely the activities and functions and objectives of League of Nations was almost 100% successful before the signing of Locarno Treaty in 1925. So we will see what happened to League of Nations after this treaty was signed. So that end all we will see in the next 2 points. By this treaty of Locarno Treaty signed in 1925, Germany, France, Belgium, Great Britain and Italy mutually guaranteed peace in Western Europe. So after this treaty in 1925, the major European powers Germany, France, Belgium, Great Britain and Italy, they were mutually means they were willing to guarantee peace in the Western Europe. So after this treaty, remember this treaty, this may be asked in the 1 mark or timeline. So remember this treaty, Locarno Treaty in 1925. So which turned the Western Europe. How means? So the major European powers like Germany, France, Belgium, Great Britain and Italy, they were mutually they were willing to or guarantee the peace in Western Europe. So thereafter Germany joined the League and was given a permanent seat on the council. So after this treaty, what happened? Germany was given a membership in the League of Nations and also given a permanent seat on the League of Nations important council. So after 2 years, US and Russia began to participate in the non-political activities of the league. So after Germany getting a membership in League of Nations, and it was given a permanent seat on the council, Secretariat Council. And after giving membership to Germany, after 2 years, USA and Russia began to participate in the non-political activities of the league, which means, so after getting giving a membership to Germany in League of Nations, after 2 years, which means 1927, Russia and US were involving in the non-political activities of league, which means certain activities or political affairs which were not recommended by the League of Nations, in that matters are non-political activities of League of Nations, they were Russia and US were wantedly are taking part in the non-political activities of league which were not recommended for the US and Russia. So with that activities of League of Nations ended, now we will see the new concept, violations, which means not following or not sticking to the policies and ideas and recommendations which were given by the League of Nations completely, which means they are not allowing or willing to follow the rules and regulations which were given by the League of Nations. Violating means not strictly following the rules or amendments or policy which were recommended by the League of Nations. What are all the violations which were violated by European powers? That in all we will see in this slide. So I will explain it one by one. One of the major problems confronting means challenging to the League of Nations is the European powers were challenging and not accepting the policies and ideas and recommendations of the League of Nations towards the achieving disarmament, which means not to use any arms and ammunition or weapons in the borders or in the world. So European powers were challenging the League of Nations to remove or achieve the disarmament, which means not to use any arms and weapons in the country or in the world. This was the first violations. The European powers were not following the principles and recommendations of the League of Nations. Next, in 1925, the Council of the League set up a commission to hold a disarmament conference to sort out the problem. So in the year 1925, Council of the League setting up a commission to discuss about the disarmament, means not to use or have any military weapons or ammunition, arms and other explosives in the borders or in the world. So regarding this, to stop the usage or practicing the army and other things, League of Nations calling for a conference and deciding a commission to stop, to not to use the arms and ammunition or weapons in the country. So but the proposed conference materialized only in February 1932. In this conference, Germany's demand of equality of arms with France was rejected. In October, Hitler withdrew Germany from conference and the League of Nations. So in the year 1925, the League of Nations recommending a commission and forming a council to stop or using the arms and weapons to discuss these issues. So but they have decided in the year 1925 to form a council and commission to stop the disarmament activities in the world. So that was materialized or that was brought into practical in the year 1932 February. So they decided to conduct a meeting on 1925 to stop using a military weapons and other arms and ammunition. But the meeting itself, when it got declared, means in the year 1925 it was declared to conduct a meeting, but it was happened or desired held in the year 1932 February. So in this conference, Germany was demanding to have a equal arms and weapons with France. So which means Germany demanding we will have a equal arms and ammunition with France. So this demand was not accepted by the League of Nations. So due to this not acceptance of the League of Nations, Germany and Hitler in October, they withdraw from the conference and the League of Nations. So this is how the European powers were violating the rules and regulations or acts of the League of Nations. So the in the next incident of violations done by Japan. Japan attacked Manchuria in September 1931, and the League condemned Japan. So the Japan also followed the example of Germany and resigned from the League. So Manchuria is a region or state or place in China. Japan decided and attacked Manchuria in September 1931, and this thing or this activity or this invasion was condemned. Condemned means opposing the invasion of the Japan. So Japan also followed the example of Germany and resigned from the League. So in the year 1931 September, Japan attacked the Manchurian region of China, and this was condemned and opposed by the League of Nations. And this attitude of League of Nations condemning the Japan, and they followed the example of Germany and they resigned from the League of Nations, and like this the major powers were violating the rules and regulations of the League of Nations. So next nation who violated the League of Nations is, you will see in the context of Italy's attack on Ethiopia, the League applied sanctions. As the sanctions came into effect, Italy resigned from League in 1937. Thereafter, the League was a passive witness to events, taking no part in the crisis over Rhineland-Austria, Czechoslovakia and Poland. So the third violation by the European powers was Italy, which was attacking on Ethiopia, and this was known to League of Nations, and they were resisting, and this should not be done further or carried to the Ethiopian borders. So the League of Nations condemning and resisting or not to do any invasion towards the Ethiopia on by the Italy. So this condemning and resisting or refusal of invasion towards Ethiopia by the League of Nations, that led to Italy resigned from the League of Nations in 1937. The last decisive action it took was in December 1939, when Russia was expelled for her attack in Finland. So in 1937, Italy attacked Ethiopia. League of Nations condemned this invasion and attacking the weaker nations, and from the resistance or condemning or opposing of League of Nations, Italy got resigned from the League of Nations and went out of the League of Nations. And the last violation was Russia attacking the Finland, and this was condemned and opposed by the League of Nations. So other major European power, Russia, who was opposed by the League of Nations to not to attack Finland. So with this resisting or condemning of not to attack Finland by Russia led to League of Nations resisted not to attack the weaker nations like Finland, and this led to, in the year 1939, Russia went out from the League of Nations, and they were following their own policies and ideas, and the League of Nations was finally dissolved in 1946. So with this, all the violations by the major European powers and great powers led to the dissolve in 1946 by League of Nations. So in the year 1947, not strictly following the rules and regulations of the League of Nations led to completely or dissolve means mottama enna aichuna League of Nations got kalanjichu mottama ve and the associations was completely kalanji adha amepe vande dissolve aichu. So dissolve or dissolving means எப்படி தண்ணியில் ஒரு பொருளை கலைச்சி அது ஒரு ஷேப் எல்லாம் கலைஞ்சி போதோ அதே மாதிரி இந்த இயர் 1946 லீக் ஆஃப் நேஷன்ஸ் வாஸ் கம்ப்ளீட்லி டிசால்வ் அண்ட் தெர் இஸ் நோ கம்போசிஷன் ஆர் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் ஆஃப் லீக் ஆஃப் நேஷன்ஸ் வாஸ் மெயின்டைன் இன் த இயர் 1946 இட் காட் டிசால்வ். So next concept will be causes for the failure of League of Nations. So what are the causes which made to the failure of League of Nations? The first causes is League appeared to be an organization of those who were victorious in the First World War I. Though it had a worldwide membership, it became very much the center of European diplomacy, which means so the main reason for failure of League of Nations is the League of Nations or United Nations organization is its members, its are mainly its supporting for the victorious nations, which means the members of the League of Nations are only the victorious nations. They are controlling the nations which were defeated, and that led to what happened, the other weaker nations and the non-members were not, their ideas and suggestions were accepted by the League of Nations. So they are dominating the victorious nations of First World War, they are dominating the League of Nations, and that led to the failure of League of Nations. The second reason for failure of League of Nations is unanimity of members was required for all its decisions on political issues. Since it lacked the military power of its own, it could not enforce its decisions. So unanimity means so everyone or all the members has to stick or should adapt to the decisions or judgment are decided by the League of Nations. They have to stick with the decisions on political issues. What are all the issues which are decided by issues and matters, decisions which are decided by members of the League of Nations, they have to stick and they have to follow the most clear decision decided by the League of Nations. Inna solla varana unanimity means edachum or decision eda design pannitaana and the League of Nations members adhu special ah und League of Nations irukku European powers edho or decisions nu decide pannitaana and the decisions kuda irukra ella members me they have to stick with that. Enna na enna solranga adha follow panniya avan kandipa, no other option, they have to strictly follow the decisions or judgment decided by the League of Nations members, especially the European powers. So due to this reason, League of Nations got failed to success their roles and duties. The next reason or causes for the failure of League of Nations is founders of this peace organizations underestimated the power of nationalism. The principle of collective security could not be applied in all practices. So in this point, what I'm trying to tell is, so the organization or League of Nations is underestimating the power of nationalism, which means the League of Nations completely underestimating the other nations. They are only doing their or restoring the peace activities among the world or around the world. So they are underestimating the patriotism or nationalism of the other nationalist members of the League of Nations. So they are forcing to under the control of League of Nations, and they are not considering the nationalism or patriotism of the other members of the nation, and that led to the failure of League of Nations. The other members were not willing to or follow the principles and peace restoring ideas of the European powers and League of Nations heads. So the next causes for the failure of League of Nations is when Italy, Japan and Germany, headed by dictators, refused to be bound by the orders of the League of Nations. So the Germany, Japan, Italy, they were dominated or controlled or by the dictators like Mussolini in Italy, Germany by Hitler. The major dictators means Kodungol Achimurai. So this major European powers like Italy, Japan, Germany, they were controlled and dominated by the dictators. So that led to what happened? The members of Germany, Italy, Japan, Britain, France were not willing or continuity in the membership in the League of Nations, and that led to the causes of failure of League of Nations. With this, the first lesson, outbreak of First World War One, ends. The homeworks will be coming in the next pages. Try to do all your homeworks in your classwork. Maintain a separate classwork for history, for the entire social science. Maintain a separate classwork notebook for the social studies. So based on the videos, I have given some book back questions. Write the answers for the questions, brief questions and the detailed questions, and also the match the following and timeline. So do this homework based on the videos. If it is not comfortable with the videos, refer the textbook and follow the answers. If you have any doubt, you just inform to your class teachers. I will share my contact numbers after some times. So try to do or write all your class works and homeworks in your social studies notebook. Maintain a separate classwork or homework for the social studies subject. Don't disturb the class teachers how to write, what to write, and where to write about the social subject. Maintain a separate classwork and homework for the social studies. I think so you might have got textbooks and classworks. So maintain a separate social subject classwork and homework. So we will see in the next session. So hereafter continuously we will be getting a videos for social subject. So with this, I'm ending this first lesson in social science in history. So next videos you will see that. Maybe in second lesson in history, or we'll move to the geography. We will change some subjects, then only it will be a little bit easier. So thank you all. Stay safe, stay home. See you in the next videos or next sessions. Thank you.